educated, engaged, and empowered to adjust to the...
The guidance that we put up was on the 10th of January. It was the 10th and the 11th of January because there were five or six technical guidance materials that were actually put up on the web, which were open to everyone. We also shared this guidance package, which included surveillance guidance on how to find cases, laboratory guidance on how to detect cases, infection prevention and control, how to prevent infections. I think saying that we may have super spreading events is something that we worry about as an organization, and we want to do everything that we can to prevent that from happening. We also put out a readiness checklist at the time for countries to say, how are we prepared to deal with a pathogen, a respiratory pathogen, and what systems do we need to put in place? And we lastly put out a disease commodity package, which listed all of the materials that one may need to detect cases, to care for cases. In terms of the development of diagnostics, the development of therapeutics and vaccines, it's really imperative that viruses are shared by all countries that have access to these samples. And given the fact that it has transmitted to a number of countries, we support the sharing of these samples to other labs so that those diagnostics, those vaccines, those therapeutics can be developed. The sequence itself of the virus was shared on the 12th, if I remember correctly. And because that happened, we had PCR assays that were rapidly developed and shared globally. I believe we posted the first PCR assay on our website on the 14th of January. And so because of that, a lot of labs were able to develop PCR assays, and so detection globally could happen very, very quickly.